Charlo. Jamal, the one that's at the IBF belt more so. You know what I'm saying? I favor him to beat all of them, but it's right now. You know what I'm saying? Andrade pretty solid, but I have to... The other twin, I don't really believe in the Jamel. I don't really believe in him. I think he on borrowed time.
I don't think either one of them looked that good they last outing, personally.
Oh, you said like against Trout? Jamal against Trout? He wasn't that bad. Trout ain't Trout tough. I mean, Laura schooled him, but Trout, yeah, I mean, Trout gave Canelo in some problems, and he kind of had it close running with Jamal. That's what I keep saying, yeah. I hate that he keep, you know, being on the losing end of the stick, but I mean, that's just the way it is at 154. Like, what the fuck you think gonna happen? Like, you, something gotta happen. Like, all y'all niggas can't be winning. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? The dude be looking depressed. He was like, man, like, after his interview after the Charlo, he was like, trying to like, man, like, he's gonna go kill himself. Like, man, I just keep winning. I mean, I keep losing. I'm like, man, he's
going to.
Man, fucking Trout, man, acting like a baby and shit, man. Like, acting all depressed. Like, nigga, you did good. And it was like, no, it was a good fight. And he was all, like, just at the post-fight energy. I was like, man, he's gonna kill himself, man. Like a little bitch. Because he lost to, you gotta think, he beat Cotto, right? He was supposed to be the next, he really was supposed to be in the superstar. Because once he beat Cotto, Trout kind of put the world on notice. They was following this guy around, they was interviewing this guy, everything. Then he got his fight with Canelo. It was a close fight. You just got hit with the wrong punch and he dropped you. So he airs you out. Then he fight Lara and then he loses bad. Then you come back around, fight the Charlo, and you lose again. So, I mean, that ain't bad. You just lost to three of the guys, the top three guys. But you beat Cotto. So I don't know what he...
I'm going to tell you, man, you know what I noticed, man? A lot of these guys, man, they sleepers. You know what I'm saying? And these top guys are losing to these guys because they sleepers. You know what I mean? Like you had Cotto go there against Trout, not really knowing too much about Trout. All he really known was he had an undefeated record. But the boy really could fight.
Mm-hmm.
Went in there and fucked around and lost. You know what I'm saying? Now you just put this man on the scene, and now he can, like, he already got that big name, so he ain't really got to fight to get the big name. He just got to keep winning. And the
right.
Same shit happened with Edmund Alexander when he tried Sean Porter. Sean Porter was a sleeper. You know what I'm saying? You didn't know too much about him. You just know he had an undefeated record. You know what I'm saying? He ain't got no crazy names on his resume like that. So at that point, you know, he go in there, sleeping on him, get his ass kicked. But the thing about it is, that nigga, he stayed consistent for a while winning. And then the fights he lose, they great fucking fighters. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
And then even with Trout lose. The only fight I've seen Trout fight that he just lost handily was against Lawrence. But everybody else, he put up a good fight. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Like these niggas, these sleepy night type niggas, man, y'all motherfuckers, hell, they don't know what they getting themselves into. And they just come out of the woodwork. See, like, it's almost impossible, niggas, like Earl Spence to be a sleeper. You know what I'm saying? Or Demetrius Andrade. You know what I'm saying? Like, these dudes are, you know, recognized, you know what I'm saying? Their talent is recognized by the mass majority. Oh, man, bro.
Yeah.
Did y'all watch?
Listen, I told you give them something visual. So you went ahead and made your own YouTube-based TV show. It's an array of IPAs and fighters on the rope. Got a question? Put them in your comment section right below. Barbershop talk while you're sitting in your living room. Pacquiao, Mayweather, and we can't forget the rules. Coming to you live with the scoops like a ladle. Allow me to introduce the boxing round table. Yeah. Rollo Jenkins, Boxologist, Zone 6. Dre, BT Pound.